Look at these pictures. We see these things in our daily life all around us. If you observe carefully, you'll see certain angles being formed. So we see these angles being formed. So there are certain angles being formed in the things we see around us in our daily life. Also, if you observe, these angles are placed next to each other. So such angles which are placed next to each other are called adjacent angles. So if you look at these angles, let us call this as angle 1 and this as angle 2. So angle 1 and angle 2 are placed next to each other. So we can say that these are adjacent angles. Now adjacent angles have a common vertex. What is the vertex of angle 1? This point. What is the vertex of angle 2? This point. So they have a common vertex. That is, they share the same vertex. They have a common arm. If you look at angle 1, then this arm of angle 1 is common to this arm of angle 2. That is, they share one arm. So this arm is common to angle 1 as well as angle 2. So adjacent angles have a common arm. Also, the non-common arms are on either side of the common arm. So now, which is the non-common arm of angle 1? This arm. Which is the non-common arm of angle 2? This arm. These two non-common arms are on either side of the common arm. So they are on the opposite sides of the common arm. And if all the three conditions are satisfied, then we say that the angles are adjacent angles. So for if any two angles, these three conditions, note all three conditions have to be satisfied and not just one or two. All three conditions have to be satisfied for them to be adjacent angles. So we have these angles here. Let us see which of them are adjacent angles. Angle 1 and angle 2, they have a common vertex. They have a common arm. And the non-common arms are on the either sides of the common arm. So yes, angle 1 and angle 2 are adjacent angles. What about this case? The vertex of angle 1 is this. The vertex of angle 2 is this. So although they have a common arm and the non-common arms are on the opposite sides, but since the vertex is not the same, these two are not adjacent angles. In this case, the vertex of angle 1 is here. The vertex of angle 2 is here. So they do not have a common vertex. This is an arm of angle 2. And this is also an arm of angle 1. So they have a common arm and the non-common arms are on the opposite sides. But the vertex is not the same. So again, these two are not adjacent angles. What if we have angles like this? So we have angle BAC, this angle. Angle CAD, which is this angle. And angle BAD, which is this bigger angle. So there are three angles being formed. Which two out of these three form adjacent angles? Let us check. First, let us check for angle BAC, which is this, and angle BAD, which is the bigger angle. That is this angle. Angle BAD. What is the vertex of these two angles? Angle BAC has a vertex A. Angle BAD has its vertex as A. So they have a common vertex. This condition is satisfied. Let us see if they have a common arm. Angle BAC has arm BA and angle BAD also has arm BA. So they have a common arm BA. So the second condition is also satisfied. Now let us look for the non-common arms. Now BAC, one of the arms is BA, which we have already taken. What about the other arm? It is AC. So the non-common arm of BAC is AC. What is the non-common arm of BAD? BAD. BA is already taken. So the non-common arm is AD. Now, they should lie on the opposite sides of BA for these two to be adjacent. AC lies on this side. AD also lies on this side. So the third condition, which is that non-common arms are on the either side of the common arm, is not satisfied. So these two are not adjacent angles. Let us check for these two. Angle BAC is this angle. Angle CAD. Angle CAD. It is this angle. So let us check. Angle BAC has vertex A. Angle CAD. CAD also has vertex A. So the first condition is satisfied. Now angle BAC and CAD have a common arm, which is AC. BAC and CAD have AC common. So second condition is satisfied. What about the non-common arms? BAC. AC is already taken. We are left with BA. So the non-common arm is BA. From CAD, AC is already taken. We are left with AD. So this is the non-common arm of CAD. Let us check whether they are on the opposite sides of AC. BA is on this side of AC. AD is on this side of AC. So yes, they are on the opposite sides of AC. So all three conditions are satisfied. Hence, these two are adjacent angles. Let us look at the third pair. Angle CAD, which is this angle, and angle BAD. BAD, which is this angle. So let us see if these two are adjacent angles or not. Angle CAD has vertex at A. And angle BAD also has vertex at A. So they have a common vertex. Now, CAD and BAD have a common arm AD. So the second condition is satisfied. From CAD, we have taken AD as the common arm. So CA is the non-common arm. From BAD, we have taken AD as the common arm. So BA is the non-common arm. Now let us check. To which side of AD do they belong? CA lies to this side. BA also lies to this side. So they lie on the same side of the common arm. Hence, the third condition is not satisfied and these are not the adjacent angles. So this condition is a very important condition, that non-common arms should be on the either sides of the common arm. for the angles to be adjacent. Now, an interesting thing about adjacent angles is that they have a common vertex and a common arm, but they do not have any common interior point. So, they have no common interior points. Let us see. What are the interior points of angle ABC, which is angle 1? We can clearly see that angle 1 and 2 are adjacent here. So, what are the interior points of angle 1? Interior points are the points which lie in the interior of the angle. So, these points, these are in the interior of angle 1. And what are the interior points of angle 2? These are the interior points of angle 2. So, these blue points are the interior of this angle and red points are the interior of this angle. We see that there is no point which is common to the interior of both the angles. So, adjacent angles have no common interior points. Now, if you look again at these pictures, we see that these are adjacent angles. These are adjacent angles. You may also note that for these adjacent angles, the non-common arms lie in a straight line. So, these are the non-common arms. They lie in a straight line. These are the non-common arms which lie in a straight line. These are the non-common arms which lie in a straight line. Such angles are called linear pair of angles. So, if we have adjacent angles whose non-common arms lie in a straight line, then those angles are called a linear pair of angles. If you recall, then angle on a straight line is equal to 180 degrees. So, this angle plus this angle should be equal to 180 degrees because these two together constitute an angle on a straight line. So, we can say that sum of measures of linear pair angles is always 180 degrees. So, linear pair means adjacent angles whose non-common arms lie on a straight line or adjacent angles which lie on a straight line. So, the sum of these angles will always be 180 degrees. Alternatively, you may say that if the sum of two adjacent angles is 180 degree, then they form a linear pair. Now, which of these three form a linear pair? If we look at this, these are the two angles. This is the common arm. These are the non-common arms. This and this are the non-common arms. They do not lie on a straight line. So, this do not form a linear pair. If we look at this, these two are adjacent angles. This is the common arm. This and this are the non-common arms, which are clearly not on the straight line. So, this is not a linear pair of angles. What about this? We have these two angles. This is the common arm. And this and this are the non-common arms, which are on the straight line. So, this is a linear pair of angles. So, among these three, only this is a linear pair of angles. And why is it called a linear pair? The word linear comes from the word line. So, these angles are along a straight line. That is why they are called a linear pair of angles. So, we have these pieces of pizza here. Let's see which two pieces form a linear pair. First, we mark out the angles which are formed by these pieces. So, this is an angle being formed. This is an angle being formed here. this is an angle being formed here, and this is an angle being formed here. So let us see which pieces add up to form a linear pair. Well, we bring these pieces together and join them. So we join them. Now we can see that this is the common arm of these two angles being formed, and these are the non-common arms. The non-common arms lie on a straight line. Hence, these two slices of pizza form a linear pair. What about these two? Let's check. We bring them together, join them. Now this is the common arm. This and this are the non-common arms. We can clearly see that they do not lie on a straight line. Hence, these two slices do not form a linear pair of angles. Now, can you answer this question? Angle 1 and 2 form a linear pair of angles. What is the measure of angle 1 if angle 2 is equal to 69 degrees? Well, we know that the sum of a linear pair of angles is equal to 180 degrees. Since it is given that 1 and 2 form a linear pair, so angle 1 plus angle 2 will be equal to 180 degrees. Or angle 1 is equal to 180 degrees minus angle 2, which is equal to 180 degrees minus 69 degrees, which is equal to 111 degrees. So angle 1 is equal to 111 degrees. So using the relation of linear pair, we can find the measure of one angle if the measure of the other angle is given to us. Now look at these three angles. Do they form a linear pair? We see that these three angles lie on a straight line. So, are they a linear pair of angles? Well, no. Pair stands for two. So, we need exactly two angles which are adjacent and which add up to 180 degrees to form a linear pair. In this case, we have three angles. So, although they add up to 180 degrees, yet we'll not call them a linear pair of angles. Because linear pair means two angles. Pair stands for two.